The outcome of this video is that it's long, but I didn't know where to cut it off. Hey! So Saturday's blog outcomes, three skills, tools, and strategies, autonomy, desired outcomes, and the gap. At the beginning of the blog, I tell this story about this little girl who's having her own experience getting over the curb on her bike. And it's my interpretation of the little girl, but that's how I interpret it, that I was just observing her having her experience, not her mom's experience, and not necessarily her brother's experience, but it was her own experience. So autonomy is, to me, it's having your own voice. It's being very clear on your own inside world and what your own opinions are and what your own feelings are. Not taking on the thoughts, opinions, beliefs, feelings of others without really examining it. Just kind of being in this constant reactive way of being in the world and not ever really being curious about how you desire to show up and express yourself. All right, so skills, tools, and strategies that help us with this sense of autonomy. I would say that autonomy is our natural state. We have our own guidance, we have our own intuition, we have our own way of being exactly who we are. And so the first thing about developing this sense of autonomy is orienting ourselves towards it, being curious about it. The next thing would be, I put bookend your day just as like a skill. And I think that that's nice to begin and end your day where you connect to your own set point, to your own center, to your own sense of balance inside of you. And a skill for you might be even being curious about that set point where you feel balanced, not too much, not too little. And then being able to express the way you really feel and trusting that if you're in this reactive state or a state where you feel extreme, but it feels like you don't have any control over it, acknowledging that and being open to having your experience and being okay with whatever that experience is, but my belief is that if you can be honest with the way you feel, it will naturally diffuse itself in a way that's okay for wherever you're at. So for example, with students, they don't need to tell me about situations, circumstances, events in their life that have happened that are troubling for them, are uncomfortable for them. But if they could go out and tell the field, if they could be in their own space, whether it's like a, if there's a space that they have where they live, in a tree, if they just had some space where they could go, where they could say exactly how they feel. I hate blah, blah, blah. Even things as extreme as I want to kill, I want to dismember, I want to whatever. If they can just have some space where they can say exactly how they feel and just keep that conversation going, I think as you release, as you diffuse like that bomb, that extreme, that it starts to naturally come into a more manageable or balanced state. And if you've ever heard of tapping, I think tapping can help this. Just tapping those energy centers in your body. I'm tapping them right now. I'm not gonna teach you tapping, you can Google tapping, but telling your story in your own way without the resistance, without the other person feeling that sense of judgment, feeling that sense of right or wrong, feeling that sense of criticism. I shouldn't hate. I shouldn't feel violent. I shouldn't feel these feelings. And just having your experience without there needing to be a right or a wrong, anything to compare to, or anything to criticize. And all right, so desired outcomes. So once we start to be curious about our sense of autonomy and finding our own voice, we can be curious about what outcomes we want. What do we want our data to present like? And that data can be things that maybe wouldn't be typical measures, you know? Like, did I smile? Did I smile? Did I laugh? What were people saying to me? Were they saying to me the things that I want them to say to me? Like, were they noticing things about me that I want them to notice? So there's all sorts of data that can connect to the outcomes that we want for our life. But our desired outcomes could be just a simple flip of, we know what we don't want to happen. We know that we just say something simple like, I know I hate that I start to get this sick feeling in my stomach on Sunday afternoon before the week starts. That used to be me. And so, knowing what you don't want, when you flip it, you know what you do want. So, what do I want? I want to feel good on Sunday afternoon. I want to feel excited for the week. So at least now we have this, like, we've thrown something out there that we can move toward. We have a desired outcome. And then once we have that desired outcome, we can choose what we want to focus on, right? We can focus on our lack of enthusiasm on Sunday afternoon, or we can focus on the desire for enthusiasm and an uplifted spirit on Sunday afternoon. So whatever I focus on is going to grow. So our ability to focus, I don't know if you would call that a skill. I mean, it's a tool for sure. But if you think about it, like right now, you could focus on anything, right? So focus is huge. But if you back up from that, you have to be aware of your focus. And then start to recognize, you know, maybe what your options are and what you desire to focus on. What I focus on is gonna grow for good or bad. It's gonna grow. So what do I want to focus on? And that's where this whole idea of having intentions for our lives comes into play, so that we feel like we are in charge of our focus, not just all the everything else in charge of our focus. So the gap is a big idea. And I think we will return to the gap and the frame often. There's always going to be this gap of where we are and where we want to be. So you can see the O is where I am, and then there's the where I want to be. So this is always going to be. There's always going to be a gap as long as we're living. There's always going to be a gap of where we are and where we want to be. And so the story we tell about this gap is huge because it can feel like this gap is happening to us, like we're doing something wrong, like we're supposed to actualize, we're supposed to master things. And it's not about not actualizing in certain areas, not mastering certain things, but that life is based on continuous growth. So there's always going to be this gap. So we get to orient towards this gap in our life, and the story we tell about it is huge. When we realize that that's just the way it is, that that's how we live, that it's it that there is a continuous growth cycle, then it's like, oh, I'm here again. So one way of managing this gap is to bring it down to something that we actually can manage. So this can often feel too big, but if we minimize it and we're like, well, like a simple example in school would be all these adults are meeting over a teenager's grades. And so all of these adults with different levels of education and awarenesses and experiences decide that this kid needs to go from getting all F's and not coming to school to getting A's and coming to school. And that needs to happen that afternoon. And that's just not reasonable, right? But to not have expectations of the child thriving isn't reasonable either. So there's this sweet spot, as always, of holding the space of that desired outcome. So if your desired outcome is that the child is engaged in school and feeling successful versus coming to school every day and getting A's, right? But what does that mean? What's the lowest common denominator of coming to school every day and getting A's? Is it that you want your child to feel engaged in life, that you want your child to feel a sense of accomplishment, a sense of success, and not holding the space for the lack of it, like what could happen, but holding the space in their becoming, holding the space in their experience, that they're gonna get there. Like in the story in the blog, like the brother talking to the sister, like, he knows she's gonna get over the curb. He got over the curb, and he's in that space of, yeah, I know, you'll get it. It's hard at first. So holding that space, being that holding that space for the other is huge. So in the case of closing the gap, we wanna just shrink it. What can I do? And that self-talk, what helped me was just, I only have to do the next thing. I only have to think the next thought. I only have to do the next thing, right? Instead of holding all of that at once, like just creates this. So the gap. And then what happens is you keep mastering these levels, and then eventually you reach that where you want to be, but then guess what? Then there's another gap, and then there's another gap, and that's how a sustainable, that's what we want to keep growing and taking what we've learned and bringing it to the next level. So sustainable growth outcomes. Shining star, no matter who.